HIPERTOUCH fire controls nest in standard AR-15 type lowers and receivers in the same way as stock AR triggers and hammers, with the addition of the toggle spring group. All the parts are made from carbon steel alloys that have been hardened for wear and strength. Shown here is the parts figure from the second page of the parts and installation manual that comes with the HIPERTOUCH 24. By the way, you can view the entire manual here online. It's found in the download tab below the video playback window on the HIPERTOUCH 24 product page at hyperfire.com. The fire control parts are identified by number, which corresponds to the parts list. You'll notice that in addition to the hammer, trigger, and disconnector, and their springs are novel parts and extra springs. Also included is a pair of small AR pivot pins of 0.154-inch diameter. I'll show you how the parts install in just a moment, but first, let me draw your attention to the table at the bottom of the figure that you'll use to set the HIPERTOUCH 24 trigger weight. Note the column on the left where the weight is listed from highest to lowest. During installation, choose a pull weight and then read across the line to the right. Where you see a bullet, read up the column and it will show you which toggle spring pair to use for that weight by part number and spring color, if any. We suggest you try all three weights to find the one that works best for your purpose. Here, I've highlighted the weight I'll use when showing you the installation process. You'll receive the trigger group assembled like this in the package. But let's explode it to see the parts more clearly. Placed over the trigger is a stock AR trigger spring. A stock AR disconnector spring and a custom HIPERTOUCH disconnector are positioned in the trigger. Over these parts is added the HIPERTOUCH frame. The pivot holes are lined up and the pivot sleeve is inserted to hold the group together. Note the notches in the sleeve. The sleeve should be rotated so that they align with the openings on the frame. This is where the hammer spring's arms will nest to retain the AR pivot pin. Now, turn the safety selector to fire and insert the complete trigger group into the AR-15 lower receiver in the usual way. The AR-15 lower is shown here by way of example. Note that it wasn't necessary to remove the safety selector. To complete the installation, insert the stock small diameter AR pivot pin. Next, notice the custom HIPERTOUCH hammer with the larger relative distance of the sear from the pivot compared to the stock hammer. This also contributes directly to lower trigger weight by reducing friction and, by the way, also reduces wear over time compared to stock. Over the hammer, install the custom AR hammer spring. Into the hole, install the toggle spindle. Now, insert this subassembly into the lower receiver in the usual way, making sure the hammer spring's arms nest in the spaces alongside the trigger group. Complete the installation by inserting the stock small diameter pivot pin. The final step involves installing the toggle springs unique to HIPERTOUCH fire controls. Three pair of toggle springs are supplied that provide for trigger weights between 2 and 4 pounds as shown in the table. Choose the color-coded pair from the figure for the trigger weight you want. Wear safety glasses. You will be compressing the toggle springs and if you inadvertently lose control, you'll want your eyes protected. Orient the lower conveniently for this step in the installation process. The toggle spring shafts have circular cutouts that should be positioned on the toggle spindle as shown, taking careful note of the asymmetric cutout features. These side cutouts should face toward the outside of the receiver as shown. Over the exposed shaft ends, place the toggle spring pair. Position the shafts as shown. Over the spring ends, place the toggle pivot and compress it slightly to hold all 5 parts together against the toggle spindle. Now, insert a blunt pointed tool into the blind hole on the back side of the toggle pivot and compress this subassembly further and rotate the toggle pivot down into the frame's pivot notch and release it, snapping the subassembly into engagement. That's it. You're done. Disassemble the HIPERTOUCH 24 toggle spring group in the reverse order and reinstall it with alternate toggle spring pairs to change trigger pull weight, according to the table I showed you.